When you look up at the stars in the night sky, do the stars stare back at you? I don't know about that. But I can tell you what makes them twinkle, what a bucket of water can do to them, why they have 5 points, and what you have in common with a star. How many stars can you see in the night sky? Every love song and poem ever written will tell you millions. Romantic as it is, it's just not true. Only if you have great eyesight and there are no clouds or any sources of light, including the moon nearby, you'll be able to spot around 2,000 stars at a time. The darker the sky, the more stars you'll notice. During a full moon or in a big city with tons of light, you'll only get to see a dozen or so of the brightest stars. Do stars really twinkle? Nope, it only seems so, especially when they're near the horizon, because the Earth's atmosphere is to blame. It has layers of different density. So, when the light from a star is traveling through these layers, it gets deflected and changes its color and intensity. So, what you see is a star that looks as if it's twinkling when it's not. If you pour a giant bucket of water on a star, will you extinguish it? Well, even if you found a way to get a bucket of water that big into space, you wouldn't put out a star. Quite the opposite, you'd make it shine brighter. What makes a star burn is a high temperature and pressure in its core. If you added all that extra hydrogen and oxygen water consists of, you'd only make the star more massive and its core pressure higher. Are all stars the same color? Well, it seems so when you look at them from Earth. But in fact, they come in different colors. Any heated object changes color as it gets hotter. So a star's hue depends on how hot it is. The hottest ones are blue. White, yellow, and orange are a bit less scorching. And the coolest ones are red and brownish. Okay, let's take a little break. I challenge you to draw a star. If you don't have a piece of paper and a pencil, use your imagination. So, what's the result? A five-armed thingy? That's how stars appear to us. But they're actually spherical like planets. So, the question is, why do they seem to have 5 points? Distant stars look pointy not only to humans, but even to super-advanced telescopes. It has to do with the nature of light. It's a unique thing that can travel both in straight paths, like a particle, and like a wave. When light comes across something on the way, its waves bounce and bend around that object, creating patterns. That's why, when you squint your eyes, any source of light seems to have pointed corners. Why 5 of them? Well, your eyes have so-called suture lines on them. These lines are at the juncture of eye lens fibers. When the light's going through the lens, it meets these suture lines and appears to you like a sphere with 5 arms. Oh, by the way, because your eyes are unique to you, stars look slightly different depending on the person. Why do stars seem to be the same size? Look at the night sky through a telescope and you'll see that stars don't have the same color and brightness. But the real size is hard to tell, because you can only judge a faraway object by how much space it appears to take up in the sky. Some stars may indeed be equally large and the same distance from Earth. Or the biggest one can be further away from us than the smaller one. We wouldn't know because they look identical from our reference point. Okay, so how can you calculate the distance to a star? The short answer? The parallax method. No, it's not 2 laxatives. To understand how it works, stretch your arm out in front of you. Now, close your right eye and put your thumb over something in the distance. Okay, open your right eye and close the left one now. Notice how your thumb moved a bit? If you know the distance between your eyes and can measure the distance your thumb moved, you can calculate how far away the object is. Astronomers do something similar with stars when they look at them from different positions and measure the distance. How do stars get their names? Altair, Aldebaran, Sirius, the dog star. The brightest stars were named thousands of years ago when they were first discovered. The biggest stars in constellations also get Greek letter names in alphabetical order. Alpha, beta, gamma, and so on. These days, thanks to telescopes, people discover more and more stars. Now, most of them go to a systematic catalog and have names consisting of numbers that represent the star's position in the sky. Plus, some stars can have names consisting of only letters. Can you name a star after your loved one? You can buy a certificate from an agency, but it won't be officially recognized by astronomers. That's why one and the same star can't be named after you and a whole bunch of other people. If you really want to go through with this plan, try naming a star on the dome of a planetarium for a donation. By the way, if you discover a comet, asteroid, or a Kuiper Belt object, you can officially give it any name you want, like Wackadoodle or something. What's the most common type of star? Red dwarfs are the most typical stars in the Milky Way. They're not quite cool, remember the color and temperature thing, and not bright enough for you to see with your own eyes. They burn slowly and can sip at their star fuel for trillions of years. The older they get, the dimmer they become. They're also 2 times smaller than the Sun, which is a yellow dwarf. How do scientists know the age of stars? They ask them, what stars tend to lie about their ages? Seriously, since they can't tell the age of a single star, astronomers look at groups of them, their brightness, and movement through space. Then they compare this data with a diagram that tells them how a star should look in this or that stage of life. In astronomy, a star born 2 million years ago is still a teenager. The average age of a Milky Way star is around 13.5 billion years. Yes, almost as old as the universe itself. I wasn't around then. Smaller stars live longer. Giants are bright but not long-lived, at least in star terms. They simply burn their star fuel faster. How do people use the stars to navigate? Polaris, also known as the North Star, will always show you where the north is. And Orion, which looks like a bent hourglass, will guide you to the south. For more advanced navigation, you'll need to have a journal and keep track of time. Then, the height of a star passing across a certain meridian will show you your latitude. Of course, a compass or GPS device might make things easier and more precise. But you can still try to figure out where you are the same way they did centuries ago. Are stars always alone? Around half of all the stars in our galaxy are binary. They come in pairs that share one center of gravity. There can also be systems of 3 or 4 stars, or even more. So, short answer, they usually have a friend or two. Are humans made of stardust? Sure are. When the universe was forming, there was just hydrogen, a little helium, and tiny amounts of everything else. Stars were working like power stations, converting hydrogen into helium. And when those stars went supernova, that event turned helium into carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, iron, and sulfur, everything you and I are made of. So you can honestly say there are elements in you that are as old as the universe. Boy, blows my mind every time. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.